In this video, I'm going to show you one of the simplest but most effective plays to run in Madden 21. What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Now, if this is your first time visiting my channel, I want to thank you for coming by, and I want to let you know that my channel is all about helping people become the best Madden players that they could possibly be. And so if you are looking to get better at this game, I want to encourage you to hit that subscribe button. That way you can stay up to date with all of the videos that we release. We release videos every single day to help you get better on the offensive and the defensive side of the ball. So if you want to get better at this game, hit that subscribe button. It's completely free and it allows you to stay up to date on all of the latest content coming from my channel. Alright guys, so in today's video, I'm going to be breaking down one of my favorite passing concepts from the bunch tight end, and that is the play inside switch. Now, there's a lot of different ways that you can run this play. Today we're going to be breaking it down as it pertains to man-to-man coverage and showing you how this can be a phenomenal man-beating concept. So all we're going to do is we are going to simply go ahead and we're going to smart route the X receiver. We're going to place the circle receiver or the triangle receiver. I actually typically like to place the triangle receiver on a slant route. We're going to smart route the square receiver. We're going to place that circle receiver on either a out route or a whip route. It's up to you, whichever way you want to do it. I personally like to use the whip route most of the time. And then that's pretty much all we have to do as far as our setup. Now, really quickly, before I show you this play, I do want to let you know that I actually have a full bunch tight end offensive guide out. So if you want to learn how I run the bunch tight end offense, that is going to be available in the description of this video. And that guide is available for just $15. So for just $15, you can learn what I believe to be one of the most effective offenses in the entire game. So I'm going to leave that link in the description. But basically, all we're going to do is we're just going to motion this triangle receiver to the right, and we're going to snap the ball right about here. Now, the trick with that little motion snap is how good of a job it's going to do at allowing your running back to get a lot of separation against man-to-man coverage. So I'll show you that again. And again, if you could just work the timing, again, real quick, the setup, we're going to place a triangle receiver on a slant. We're going to place that circle receiver on a zig. We're going to smart route the square receiver and the X receiver, which is a tight end in this case. And then the first read on this play is going to be the running back. The running back quick to the sideline there. There's going to be a nice little natural pick and rub that is oftentimes going to allow you to be able to hit that running back, especially if they are man-to-man blitzing you. So if you're worried about man-to-man pressure, that is one of the best pressure beaters in the entire game. Now, the next little read that I'm going to have is you're going to notice that this circle receiver is going to absolutely toast his man-to-man coverage. And the primary reason why is because it is an unbumpable route. So as long as you have a really good route running receiver in that position, you are going to have a lot of success against that man-to-man coverage. Now, the next read on this play is going to be the X receiver, and you're going to see that this X receiver will oftentimes be able to get separation to the outside. One little footnote on this is if you have a tight end that has really good route running in mutt, for example, like a Vernon Davis or a Darren Waller, you are going to have a lot of success with that route. That is one of the most powerful routes in the entire game, especially just because of the speed at which he gets open. Now, in regs, you're not going to have as much success because Robert Tonyan doesn't have the route running. But if that was Travis Kelce or something like that, because of the route running, because of the way that route works, you're going to have a lot of success. Now, you will occasionally have some success with this. I'm not going to say that you won't. As you saw right there, you see I'm able to complete that if I want to, or if I can possession catch that, that would work. But what I want to be clear about is if you have the route running, it's going to be a lot better for you, especially if a lot of people, when they run man-to-man, what they like to do is they like to shade their coverage to the inside. If they shade their coverage to the inside on a play like this, that's where it's really going to get a lot of separation. As you saw right there, when they're starting to shade more to the inside, you're going to have a lot of success with just that one little simple thing. So as you can see, those are the routes that beat man. Now, the last two routes that I want to cover is this little motion slant. This motion slant is a very consistent little read for man-to-man coverage. It's been consistent all year. The beauty of this motion slant is, let's say that they're putting their zone drops at 25 to 30 yards to be able to stop like crossing routes and things like that. This motion slant is going to do a really good job at just getting the simple separation all the way across the field. The same can be said for that square route. As you see, it's a nice little sharp cut to the inside. So this route, literally, I think every or this play, I believe every single route beats man-to-man coverage. And so that's part of what makes it so effective. But the beauty of this play is it's not just good against man. It's good against zone as well. As you guys probably remember, that little quick throw is a phenomenal little pass against zone coverage. If they're not playing disciplined with their coverage, if they're not using that, if they're not in a good position to stop that, just throw that little quick route over and over and over again. And then the other read that you have is you have this nice little corner route. You also have a motion slant, which again, like I said, let's say that they're trying to jump down and take away like the flats and things like that. That's where this little motion slant and that corner route are really going to shine. Basically, you just sit in the pocket. And as you can see, that slant comes open very late in the play. So this is one of my favorite passing plays in the entire game. I personally think it's one of the best passing plays in the entire game. And it comes out of just a phenomenal passing offense with in which you can literally dominate your opponent with about 5 to 6 plays in our bunch tight end offensive guide. So if you want to start dominating on the offensive side of the ball, I want to encourage you to go ahead and pick up that bunch tight end offensive guide. I'm going to leave a link to that in the description. If you use that link, you'll be able to get that bunch tight end offense for just $15. Thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate it. And if you have any questions, you can always text me. My cell phone number is 208-218-6900. And if you want to get that bunch tight end offensive guide, I'm going to leave a link in the description of this video.